Thank you all so much for being here and for sharing your artwork with us and the incredible spirit that you have delivered with that. I'm so deeply grateful for your work. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Xochitl Torres Small, and I have the great honor of getting to represent you in Congress. So I'm so excited to be here this afternoon to meet you virtually and host this event highlighting the many talented high school students in my district. You all know what a difficult time this is in New Mexico. The challenges of not being able to interact the way you normally do, and just the way that you and your teachers and families have navigated and adjusted to remote learning. Also dealt with the economic challenges when it comes to your parents and figuring out how to continue to do work given the impacts of COVID-19 and the closures that we've seen because of that. So provides an opportunity to process challenges, to build community and explore solutions. And I so appreciate you being part of that. This year's submission certainly reflects the very strength of what makes New Mexico so unique. So I want to thank all of the artists and their parents who participated, the art teachers for their dedication to their students in this project, and the many constituents across New Mexico's 2nd Congressional District. As you know, we did this competition a little different this year, having our constituents support the work by voting in this competition. It isn't said enough, but an arts education is so critical and necessary in developing well-rounded and well-prepared students and future leaders. For me, it was in theater and music. Theater taught me empathy and the ability to see multiple sides of a situation. And music taught me that listening to different instruments and working to join together can often create a more powerful sound. But from all of it, I think when you were working on the arts, you learned the value of practice and hard work as a fundamental piece of any product. So as I looked at your submissions, I was incredibly amazed at how artists of all ages were able to take the essence of who we are as a community and translate that into something tangible. The gifts you share allow us to further understand ourselves and our neighbors. The young artists whose work is here tonight are part of something bigger than themselves, and I'm so proud to get to be part of your journey here tonight. Of course, the arts aren't just a creative outlet. They've also been shown to help students sharpen their critical thinking skills, learn math, and improve academic achievement. Creating art encourages young people to express themselves and take risks, helping them to develop a sense of innovation that will be important throughout their lives. Because of all of this, each year, Congress sponsors a nationwide high school art competition to recognize and encourage the artistic talent of the nation. The winner tonight will have their art featured in a year-long exhibit at the United States Capitol. Our honorable mentions will have their work displayed in my district offices. All of the art here tonight is, or here virtually tonight, is worthy of our admiration, and it was such a joy to get to view and learn from. So I thank you all so much for sharing a little piece of your work and your soul. And reflecting the power and beauty of our communities. Before I announce the winner, I want to recognize our 10 honorary mentions. First honorary mention for best representation of nature is the Rio Grande Gorge by Tyler Sines of Fort Sumner High School. Tyler, congratulations. Next honorary mention for best representation of an animal is horse by Madison Miller from Lawrenceburg High School. Congratulations, Madison. Next, the honorary mention for what stood out to you is Cheetah by Tina Martinez at Lawrenceburg High School. Next honorary mention is Recuerdos de mi Cultura by Alfredo Gutierrez from Gadsden High School. Congratulations. Next is Untitled by Ashley Drake from Gadsden High School. Next is Dot Painting by Alaya Palumbo from Lawrenceburg High School. Next is Lion from Isaiah Placencia from Lawrenceburg High School. Then we have James Camacho Jackson from Gadsden High School, who did Untitled. Next is Brady from Julio Lozoya from Lovington High School. And the last honorary mention is also Untitled by Priya Simpson from Carlsbad Early College High School. And I'm pleased to share this year's winner for the 2020 Congressional Art Competition. Congratulations to our winner of the competition, Best Representation of New Mexico, Chase Williamson from Fort Sumner High School, for your Ristra of the Southwest. Thank you again. You young artists have generously shared your work with us today, and I hope you continue to do that, to continue to explore and take risks and find beauty and work to identify challenges and opportunity and show them in a tangible way when it comes to your art. I'm so deeply grateful that you are all New Mexicans, and it makes me have great hope for our future. It's been an honor to join you this afternoon, and I hope that you and your family continue to stay healthy and safe and well in these challenging times. Thank you all so much.